early afternoon game in baseball as we look at the standings. Red Sox six back in the American League East standings. It is 7 in the loss column, and they are 4 back of the Tampa Bay Rays, and that's where it's gotten interesting. I think the belief was if you split these games with New York, Tampa Bay keeps winning, you might be 6 or 7 out of everything. But what's happened is Tampa Bay has lost 5 in a row, and you have made up some ground now. A game and a half in these 4 games with Tampa Bay going tonight. That's what you've made up in the wild card.
And you can't go back saying if we were just won a couple of games over the weekend, you get closer. I'll tell you what, Toronto's going to try to wreck your day is what they're going to try to do. They think they're like 4 games within the play, you know, to the wild card. So they're going to be ready to play tomorrow night.
The thing you see there is a 149 team batting average. We talk about the Red Sox not scoring a lot of runs. This Rays offense is in trouble. Carlos Pena, the only guy on the team with more than 15 home runs, is on the DL.
And you see, how do you see it getting better? They put so much pressure, really, on Longoria and Crawford, because those are your two stable guys out of the whole lineup, and they haven't got a guy to lead off. I mean, I never thought it was a good lineup to begin with, let alone take out Pena, and they're in trouble. So their pitching has got to carry them, and when you're getting 1 run a game, you got no chance.
And 40% of their starting rotation is being examined today for shoulder situations. They were almost no hit yesterday for the 3rd time this season. That has never happened in the history of Major League Baseball. Our KGB question of the day: which was the most impressive pitching performance of the year? And overwhelmingly, you say Morrow's 17 strikeout, 1 hit performance. In a year where we've seen a lot of no hitters, that was as good.